Well, we're nearly set for the women's 3-4 playoff, Al.
Yeah, so bronze medal on the line. Players just starting their backhand warm-up and just getting prepared again. Interesting to see how these two players settle into this match. Probably the biggest match that these two girls have ever played. They would never have competed for an international bronze medal of this calibre. So there definitely will be a little bit of nerves starting up.
Look, Natalie, I can tell you, the Kiwi, Natalie Patterson, she's consistently worked hard, Solenn on picture there momentarily, but she's put in a lot over these last 4 or 5 years. Her game has improved, it has developed. She had a big weakness on the forehand side, but that seems to have been gone, seems to be gone now. So, yeah, all set, here we go. Big match.
Solenn Danger looking quite calm.
First game.
Sometimes it's hidden underneath.
Lovell.
It's not what you see on the outside, Al.
Lovell, Danger to serve.
Ooh. One, love.
Good little topspin serve to the awkward forehand area. That one too high. And Patterson just disposing of that ball. So, two serves there, same area, but first one nice and low, second one too high, and just made a big difference for Patterson.
She sometimes gets a little bit jumpy. She starts bouncing a little bit too much, Natalie, and then she'll lose that rhythm. She's just sort of really maintain her balance, choose her shots, instead of bouncing a bit too much. We'll keep an eye on that. That's a right shot to be playing. They'll start coming. That'll start getting on the table. She's just got to get a bit more air on that ball. It's a good start for both girls here, 2-all.
So a change up of serve that time. That one going deep into the backhand. But Patterson coping with that one very easily. She liked that.
First time a New Caledonian features into the 3-4 playoffs for some time now. New Caledonia on the way back to international table tennis in the Oceania region. And then obviously in the previous match featuring in the Pacific Cup final too. Good tournament for the New Caledonians. Both girls look like they belong though, don't they?
They've settled in really well. I like it. Patterson's missed a couple of backhand openers here.
So there's that bounce I'm talking about. It's just a bit too much. There are two or three bounces in between the shot. If she can time it right, it's perfect. She'll make the ball. But it just takes a bit of time for her to get that rhythm. But then as the match progresses, if you're onto it, you can change the rhythm of your shot to account for her bouncing.
5-4.
That's that really flat forehand by Danger.
Short points at this point. Spin.
4-6.
So a bit of a contrast in styles here. Solenn playing very flat. Patterson playing with some spin there, you see.
Patterson's avoiding that forehand smack as well. She's got a big forehand smash, young Solenn.
Five, six.
Starting to warm up, Al. First sign of the big smash.
Yeah, and when she
Here
lands.
We go. Here she comes. Boom! Just got
not
there a
quite,
bit slow, though.
Not
just a
quite.
Bit. Yeah. It's coming. There it is.
Seven.
I like it.
There it is. I've been telling you all along, Al.
That is not an easy ball to play.
No, that's huge.
Watch this.
Boom! Seven, five, danger with a big smash. She's going to have to stay away from those forehand smashes, eh?
You know, yes and no. You know, yeah. How many can she land? Can she get enough variation into that forehand to make it?
Well, that's what happened with Tapper, right? I mean, has Patterson got that, though?
Eight, five.
And then you got the whip there, right? I mean, you can see she was on the right idea there, Patterson, trying to get that ball into the middle. Watch it here. Into the middle, which would have cramped her up that little bit. But she's got to land it. So Patterson's on the right track.
Five, nine.
That serve of danger is interesting. Yeah. Backhand serve, she's getting a bit of variation with it.
I mean, the other thing with that smash, Al, is the perceived pressure that you'll end up having as well. You'll start getting nervous about where to put the ball, and then those serves, like you're saying, becomes a lot more difficult to get back.
Jeez. 5-10.
I mean,
the younger of the two girls seems just so settled, right? Patterson's just finding it hard to calm down. First time they might have played, these two girls. There's no head-to-head officially. ITTF.com, they keep a record of all the head-to-heads. There's another one.
10-6.
It wasn't the big one, though. It was the medium one.
And Patterson onto that one. Just made Solenn Danger play one more ball.
Ten, seven.
I saw Danger play at the end of a match against Georgina Newton, and it was just an absolute cracker of a match. It was, I don't know, 15-13 in the deciding set.
I think
and
she came,
every ball.
She came back from about 10-7, I think. Against the
11-7.
There it is,
game
first
Danger.
Set. Solenn Danger takes it 11-7.
To love.
So, yes, looking very composed there, Danger. She settled in beautifully, got the serves working well. Variation of the placement of the serve. I like the first serve she did, the lower one, shorter to the forehand.
Yeah, to the forehand side.
Yeah, but just that variation.
That was
throwing.
At the backhand, right?
Yep,
yeah,
backhand
serve.
And Patterson didn't quite settle in. Missed a couple of opening opportunities, missed a couple of balls in the rally that, you know, normally she will make. But it's important that you just, you know, keep hanging in there, just keep making that topspin. So when Patterson can get into a bit more rhythm with her spin and just start to load that ball up a bit more.
Sorry to interrupt you. We've got Michael Brown in the background there, ITTF representative. I mean, that's the other thing with the sport of table tennis. We have so many different roles and places for people to, pathways for people to go through in the sport of table tennis. I mean, whether it's running local events, state events, national events, participation's high right around the world. You know, the whole team working in the background there to put this whole event together. Over 150 athletes represented through the Oceania region, qualification process all the way through. Thought I'd just throw that in, Al. Here we go. Sorry to interrupt you.
No, that's good. It's pretty important to recognise those people.
So Solenn looks at home here in the 3-4 playoff. Big payday ahead for the young 17-year-old.
Second game.
So Patterson's got to just...
I reckon everyone at home's going to want to be friends with her.
Yeah, let's find her on Facebook.
That's what I'm talking about. Starting to find that rhythm. I'm telling you, Al, this Kiwi can play. She's got a nice, solid game. I like her body size for the game of table tennis, too. She's nice and strong. Covers the court easily. Just got to find that rhythm. There's that backhand spinny ball.
And she missed a couple of those in the first game, so this is a real difference.
Check out the reaction from Patterson, too, after she wins this point. She lets the youngster know, hey, I'm not going to give you this. Oh, missed it there, Al. Let's keep an eye out for it.
Yeah, she's definitely been a bit more vocal in game two as well.
Yeah, absolutely. Down low, nice and focused. It's that backhand serve. You want it into that forehand.
Love, three.
And
there's a big smack.
Yeah.
I'm going to keep count on this one, Al. That's 1-1 I'm giving it. One win, one loss. Let's just keep track. I think the smack's going to be the winner here.
Three,
and it's
one.
Just the avoidance of the smack too. I mean, spinning the ball down the line, shorter angles.
You know, if I was Patterson, yeah. I would exploit it. You know,
yeah.
I think you can break down that smack.
Absolutely.
But you have to go in there with plenty
You've
of spin and
variation.
You've got
to have the confidence too, though, to do it now.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what we saw Tapper earlier in the day. There it is, out wide to the forehand.
One.
Nice strategic play. Didn't even get a bat to it. I mean, Tapper had that confidence to do this on a more regular basis, like you're saying, and just break down the topspin, the smack.
Yeah, the short pimples that Danger uses on the forehand is difficult to use too.
Two, four.
Yeah, that short pimple, Al, absolutely. Perfect for the old smack.
But it can break down too, you know, like if you can put enough spin into that pimple, that it's a difficult ball to control.
Five.
And an error.
So
another one on the right-hand column, Al?
Yeah, absolutely. And this is it, you know, like... If you can break,
can't
down
be
the
missing
confidence.
That though, Danger.
Yeah.
That's ours. Yeah. That's in our column.
Five, four.
Good composure though on that long fast serve. Just a little bit of a spin ball.
And that match I was talking about earlier, when she played against a young Aussie, you know, showed so much composure in tough points. Just
these international events, they. It's going to grow in them.
Four,
as I said,
six.
She's a two-time cadet, World Cadet Challenge representative. The last one was held in Beijing. I think the one prior to that was in Rome. So she's been to Rome and Beijing for table tennis.
Four,
Patterson
seven.
Avoiding that forehand, and her game is starting to come out now, right? I mean, she's putting balls on the table and keeping it away from that backhand, that forehand smack.
Eight, four.
Yeah, it's a nice contrast of styles here. Patterson with the spin.
I feel like Danger's just looking for it too much now, though. She's looking for the way to win the point rather than just play the point for what it is, keeping the rally.
Yeah, play one or two more balls on the table.
Yeah.
Let Patterson make the mistake too.
Where Patterson's just adjusted to her style now.
Nine,
she's been
four.
Precise out to that forehand, hasn't she?
Yeah. I like it.
Two unforced errors out to the forehand. One winner and two clean winners out to the forehand. Two strategic winners out to the forehand side. Really working that backhand side otherwise. Smart play. There's that short one to the forehand and
four.
Bang, Patterson.
Ten.
She's all over her. As the youngster... Got what it takes to turn this around. I mean, this is the point in the match where you start in the set, where Coach Kathy starts thinking to herself, okay, how am I really got to turn this around now? I mean, the player's shown no signs of turning it around.
11,
that
four,
goes in that right-hand column, doesn't it, Al?
It does. What have we got?
We've got three unforced errors out to the forehand. We've got one clean smackaroo on the forehand side. But then we've also got two in the column where Patterson has forced the error. And on those two occasions, the youngster, Danger, didn't even get a bat to it. So, in a sense, not that dangerous.
That's it. So,
all square, one all, baby.
So, Kathy,
Coach Kathy, getting to work.
Yeah, so trying to get it.
So
really,
this would be one of her pupils back home here, Al. New Caledonia wouldn't have a, you know, a number of clubs. They'd all be working together as one big club, basically.
Yes.
And Coach Kathy is one of the long-serving coaches out there, working with all the kids that come through.
Patterson now getting her instruction.
The Auckland club, a really prestigious club out in New Zealand. Patterson, most of her work out at the Auckland club. They've been really well represented here at this event. Their junior team performed outstandingly this week. They actually dominated the boys' side of things. They won the under-18 boys' singles. They won the under-18 boys' doubles. They fell short in the teams event. The Aussies got up 3-0. Great work from the New Zealanders and great from the Auckland team. Here we go, we're all set.
One game apiece.
So it's all about third just game, a few more shots on the table here and not level. Rushing it. Is that what we're going for, Al?
That's it.
There's another ball. I think that one was more forced. I think that was a forced error out to the forehand. Just couldn't keep up with the speed.
Yeah, but I think she tried to do too much. You know, that's a block, not a smack.
Yeah. She attempted the smack. I'm just trying to get our columns right here. Al, I feel like she attempted the smack.
Attempted smack.
Yeah.
We'll put that in the attempted error. Attempted smack, forced error column.
Yeah, all right, good. I think the other thing with danger, she's got to find a way to get that forehand working.
Two.
Yes. What I mean by that is find where do I serve? And I think in this case, she's going to have to play, like you said, two or three more shots. But how do I strategically play one shot out wider, maybe one shot shorter, which is going to force Natalie to play to my forehand for me to then smack it. So there's, there you go, a push to the forehand, out wide to the forehand. Here we go.
One.
That was what we've been talking about.
Yeah, and I think even after that push to the forehand, she should be around and just...
There you go, she could have found her own smack. Yep.
And good spin by Patterson. I like that. I like that top spin a lot.
Fantastic.
If she can play with spin, and she would have been watching Tapper play Danger earlier.
Absolutely.
And she would have seen Danger's blocking breakdown. That's a good position of the serve by Danger. So it needs to be into that forehand. I like just the variation. That one was longer. Also the short one to the forehand.
Well, she's had a lot of success there. And by avoiding that forehand side, the table is shorter from down the line, and it's been forcing that error. She's going to have to find maybe a sequence of about seven different serves in that area, Al. Different positions, different spots, different spins, different speeds.
Two.
Fault that time by Patterson. Going for the deep one.
It was worth the risk.
Yeah, it looked all right. I mean, Danger.
Might have been worth the risk.
Danger was in trouble if it...
2-5 now, though. And I don't feel like it feels like a 2-5 game. It should be 3-all or something. Both girls are...
Yeah, nothing much.
Yeah.
Five.
Bit of nerves. Both girls know that's an important moment. That was an unforced error there.
That one too high.
Four.
And we saw that in the first game as well.
So nothing on it. Spin it.
Going for the forehand serve.
Five.
Just a little
thrown
breakdown.
Thrown away that lead.
Yeah, just a little breakdown there by...
We're halfway through the set here, Al, and not one forehand shot from Danger.
Yep.
And it's been two sets since she's actually hit one for a winner.
Six. God. Five.
Yeah, I know.
That's in the right
column. I know, Al.
Put
right
that,
column.
Put that down.
It's another miss. But it was so close.
Yeah, but
another one in that right hand column.
Glenn Errington isn't awarding points for close here.
Can we start another column, Al?
Five.
There's been a lot of unforced errors here in these last 4 or 5 points by Danger.
It's also getting used to it, though, isn't it? I mean, you know, at 5-2, I mean, as you develop as a table tennis player, you start to know when the important moments are. And you start to feel it, and you try and do that little bit more to make sure of the moments. And it's getting used to it. I mean, she's probably overdone it a little bit, overcooked it. And now from 5-2, she's finding herself down 5-7. And it's a new scenario now. Now it's a battle to stay alive. And interestingly, she's then gone to what we talked about, keeping that ball on the table.
Yeah, and there just needs to be a little bit more of this. See
that white forehand
yep.
Side to side.
Yep.
But she kept the ball on the table.
Bouncing around, just getting her legs moving. Serving with the pimples.
Eight, six.
And is that good spin that you talk about?
Yeah, I really like that spin that Patterson can put on the ball. And when she can get it into
down low, she gets down low, uses that leg a little bit.
And Danger lifts that backhand block off a few times.
8-6. This is a big point now for Danger. Can she stay in the game? Good spot to serve. Oh, huge shot from Patterson.
Have we got a smack forehand column for Patterson?
We haven't, but I think we should start one. I think she's on top. She's done two in this set.
Well, that's right. And that's twice as many as Danger.
Incredible.
In the whole match.
Incredible. Hell. Two, and I'm giving her another one because I feel like I saw one earlier.
Six,
just by playing the smart game, up 10-6, her weapon's being used a lot more than Danger's. And to more effect.
And Patterson got a bit of confidence about it. Danger now looking a little bit despondent.
How the game can turn. Is that spin?
11, 6.
Yep,
game,
right,
well.
Another one in
Patterson
my column.
Leads, two games,
okay, so
one.
What have we got? We've got five misses on that forehand side. Her weapon, basically, Al. Her weapon is being eliminated. She's missed five. She's made one. She's had three forced errors out in that area. Meanwhile, Patterson, New Zealand, she's sitting really, really pretty. I mean, she's hit three good forehand winners. 11-6 in the previous set, 11-7 the set before that, after losing the first set. It's getting easier.
Yes.
Coach Cathy's got some work to do.
Yeah, and I think she just needs to settle it down. But, okay, so she's talking about there.
You can just see the body language there, Al, like you're saying.
Just pushing that ball down the line. She wants it
there
to push
you go.
The ball down the line. Yeah.
It's so important, and you'd be ideal to talk to us about this and talk us through it. The body language that the coach comes with after that set, it's 1 minute, and basically you can tell the player a lot, but just by your body language. If you want them to calm down, you stay calm as a coach. If you want them to fire up, you become a bit more fired up. What's Cathy doing? Do you think she's trying to fire her up, or is she telling her to calm down?
I think she's very animated about a point or two that she wants Danger to implement. Danger looks
critical points.
Yeah. A couple of critical points. She was talking about pushing that ball down the line from her forehand, and she's been talking about the punching through with the backhand on the block.
Well, it's being attacked, right? So you need to do something there before we start talking about that forehand side.
Yeah, because she just lifted a couple of backhand blocks off the end of the table. So,
golly, I've read this wrong, Al. It's all about the backhand. 2-1, Patterson.
One.
If you've just joined us, it's 3-4 playoff, Oceania Cup.
Bronze medal on the line.
We've got 17-year-old Danger from New Caledonia in the pink. And then we have Patterson in the black from New Zealand. 24-year-old Patterson. Lost the first set. And it's come back and won two. I think that's one in the wrong column, isn't it?
It is.
One in the new column. Just a bit more spin required there, Al.
And it was a little bit lower.
Yeah.
So,
it's a bit like that previous match. You start getting used to the serves, start getting used to the things that the person's doing. It gets a bit lower, but you're not seeing it as the recipient. Did you see that forehand, Al?
Yeah, that
was a spinnier, slower, more controlled.
And Danger put four balls on the table there.
That.
Let's have a look.
Look at
just
that forehand.
On the table.
She
on
just
the table.
Kept it on the table.
On the table, and it was Patterson that made the error.
Wow. Coach Cathy. The girl's listening to the coach, isn't she?
Three.
She's really listening to the coach, trying to do what the coach says,
and
places a lot of trust in the coach, Al.
That's right, and that's why Cathy was pretty animated about what she wanted to say, because she could obviously see a couple of things pretty clearly that she wanted to change.
One, four.
Looks like she's just trying to get her to push into Patterson's backhand there.
I feel like there's a pressure moment coming through now. 4-1 for Danger. The previous set she was out 5-2, was it, Al?
Yeah.
Four.
Again,
4-2.
Just had to keep that ball on down the line like the previous rally that she'd used that for in this one here. Just control it up.
Yeah, trying to do too much.
Yeah, went for a bit too much. 4-2, Patterson controlling the time, going to the towel every 6 points.
And Danger, on that last ball, almost got a bit too close to it. You know, she was like almost jumping at it. And instead of just controlling, as you said, just control that ball with the forehand.
Emotion's taking over a little bit here, isn't it? She gets up 4-1, and she thinks to herself, I've got to do something. Good spin.
That was better.
Five,
another block,
two.
Straight to the forehand. I must confess, I have coached against Patterson before, and the forehand was the side that we worked on as a team. I thought it could just break. So there is a hole there. The backhand is a lot stronger than that forehand side. Good spin. Good spin from Danger. 6-2. Patterson knows there's a threat right now, doesn't she?
His forehand.
Good
That's
spin.
A really different forehand than she's been trying in the first
bit vocal
games.
There as well, stamping her own authority. Nice legal
Two,
serve there, Al. Open hand, open palm.
Yeah, so the rule says that you have to have your hand nice and flat. And that's a good backhand topspin.
Just clipped the edge, didn't
back
it?
End, yeah.
Perfect length. Lucky or precise, Al?
Precise.
That's
Let's
what
get
I always
precise.
Say.
8.
Pushing that
two.
Ball down the line.
This match is getting interesting. 8-2.
Yeah, so there has been a real change in what Danger is trying to do. Just putting a few more balls on the table, pushing the ball down the line.
Is that serve to the forehand?
Nine.
Straight out to the backhand.
Yep, so Patterson covered the serve well, but then wasn't able to get back quickly enough.
Talked about that in some of the previous matches, the importance of footwork, not just side to side, but coming in, coming out, how quickly you can make that preparation.
Three.
That's another good strategic play there from Patterson. Yes. Like to the forehand, long to the backhand.
When she can make
that. Look at that wide that ball
beautiful.
Was up.
And then I like just that top spin ball.
Good spinny ball. Nothing special. 9-3 goes to the towel. 9-3. Going to the towel at every 6 points. Part of her routine.
And just, you know, making the young girl wait.
Yeah.
Make her think about her 9-3 lead.
Let
the ball
three,
just clipping the top
nine.
Of
four
and
nine.
A bit of noise there from Patterson.
She's not going away,
no,
is she?
No, just letting the young girl know that okay, I'm still here.
You still got to close it out, don't you? I'm just going to give it to you, kiddo.
Ten.
And that's the weakness in the forehand that you saw before.
Yeah, that's just rushed. She sometimes goes a bit too flat, a bit too small. Wow, this spin clips
four.
The edge.
Game, danger.
We've got a match on our heads. Alois, it's 2-2 here. 3-4 playoff. Coaches go back to work with their players.
Let's see what Kathy comes up with now.
We'll take a short break.
Thank you. We'll be right back.
Patterson, a bit of work ahead of her. She knows she's got a game on her hands. Two games apiece.
He's a very cool, calm and collective coach, isn't he? He's not getting too emotional.
Time.
He just talks about precise points, what changes need to be made. A Kiwi coach, an expert. Been around, controlled that whole team for the entire week. As I said, those New Zealand boys are doing a great job. And now Natalie Patterson playing for 3-4. He's got a pretty busy schedule ahead of him. He's got another match
fifth
after
game.
This.
Danger serving. Lovell.
Well, we didn't actually add anything to the danger column for that set. So that whole forehand strategy's changed throughout this match. But I'm sure
Lovell.
It'll come back at some point.
Love one.
Yeah, just reaffirming it to herself. That's what I need to be doing. I just need to land it.
Rushing a little bit, though. Rushing that point, you know, like she was looking for the winner, trying to go so wide. Just get it into the forehand. Don't need to hit the white line. The element of safety. There's that forehand up.
Two, love.
A bit of hesitation on that forehand. She had to control herself and say, hey, don't hit it. Watch it. She wanted to hit it, and she said, no, don't hit it.
Eyes lit up.
No, don't hit it. No. Oh, God. What do we got? What's the score? Two love, Patterson. Off the danger serve. Long pass serve. Nice one. Defensive rally.
Three,
testing each other
love.
Out. Good spin.
That's the
love.
Spin that we
want. Yeah, I know, Alois, that column it. Again. The time she misses that smash, Alois just turns straight to me.
Watch it. Loads up. And oh. Yeah. And that's weird. When you're playing with that amount of spin by Patterson, the ball just dips and ducks a bit, and it makes it difficult.
1-4.
All right, so danger gets on the board. Umpire Glenn Errington lifts that left arm and signals. She's on the board.
Where will she go with this serve?
Nice play.
Four,
bit of cat and mouse.
Two.
She didn't play the big forehand on that second one. Watch this. So she played the controlled backhand. This was the right idea. I feel like now she should have played the smack. Instead, she's played the backhand. Back to the towel for Patterson. Taking her time. It's a good sequence of 6 points for Patterson. 4 wins, 2 losses. Does that again. She'll be up 8-4. How far ahead do players think, Al?
Next point.
Yeah. Just 1 point at a time, eh?
5-2.
Clip the net. Nice lucky one there.
Interesting. I think when you're serving, you know, maybe you've got two serves that you think, okay, I'm going to do this serve this point and that the next.
Let 5-2.
And you may even have an overall game plan. You know, you want to serve 80% here, you know, 20% there.
Yep. But then how do you play it? You're thinking one at a time, and you know your statistics of how many you should have done.
2-6.
Well, sloppy set here from Danger. A lot of simple errors. Keeping that intensity. Playing with the seniors.
Three,
now.
6.
It's another level of intensity, isn't it?
And she's had a lot of matches these few days.
I reckon it'd be around the 30 matches up she would have played.
6-4.
To get to this point. Credit to the young girl. 6-4, holding it together. Push to the limits. School holidays, she's out here competing. Fantastic. Wow.
Where should we put that one?
I'm taking that one out.
You're taking
our
it.
Second.
Let's have a look at it. Let's
Yeah, maybe just give it to Niel because I need one in that column. But it wasn't the typical smack. It was a bit spinnier. As we go to a timeout, Al. Called by the Kiwis, I assume.
Yep. So
the cool cat from New Zealand's called timeout.
Yeah,
he looks a little bit more concerned now, though. He's frowning a little bit, Al.
Yeah.
And these are the sort of signals subconsciously players pick up without actually picking it up. He's got to remain cool, ask a few questions. That's what he's doing there. He's asking a few questions, making Natalie think about it. 6-5, it means they want this set. They do want this set. I mean, sometimes it's a bit early for a timeout. It's only 2-all, 6-5.
It is.
You can claw yourself back from 2-3-2 down. The new Cal team, Coach Cathy, has just sent her girl back out and said, you know what, you're good. You're good to go. We're in control.
Even though you're down a point.
You can't see this on TV, but we're watching live. There she is. She's just bouncing around, keeping those legs moving. She's got this under control, Al.
She looks like she's about to punch someone.
Oh, it's really important to keep those legs moving. As soon as they become flat-footed, you start standing still. Ball goes wide to your forehand, you don't make that movement, so keep that blood moving. All right, we're back.
Match resumes.
We got 6-5.
Yep.
Patterson. Serve. 5.
Yep. Patterson the serve.
Be interesting to see where she serves this ball.
Long middle, I'd go, Al.
Short forehand.
She went the long middle.
Long middle, Simon.
I think we need a new column. She did miss the smack too there, Young Danger. She missed the smack. She teased her with the smack. So that goes in that column, but we are starting a new column, the Alois versus Gerada column. And we're starting it at the appropriate time when Gerada gets the first one right. I feel like Alois got a couple right earlier and we didn't start it then. The column system just arrived.
You're in charge of the column system.
I'm in charge of the column. We've got lots of columns.
Unfortunately, I don't have a piece of paper and a pen to start my
columns. Your own column. Back to the match, Al. That was a good control smack.
Yeah, I like that. I like that control. She's got to put those balls on the table there.
Yeah, she's pulled it back. And that's a credit to the girl. I didn't think she had this in her. I didn't think she could really manage that sort of play. Her earlier round, she didn't show any in between. It was either just a nothing or a smack.
Yeah, well, we saw Coach Cathy. That's what she wanted her to do.
7-all. Wow. This is a real pressure moment. What's it?
Yeah, especially after Patterson called the timeout, you know. It's
good serve. Yeah, they've used up their timeout. You only get one a match. There's no second timeout. That was a good serve, though. There's that middle one fast one again.
Oh, got the high ball, but should have gone the forehand.
Yeah, she should have went the forehand. The pivot, it's worked so well for her. She just stood there.
Look, she's got plenty of time.
Just stood there. Yeah. Couple of bounces there, those bounces that I don't like. 8-all. It's still anyone's game.
Well, 2-all, 8-all.
Pretty obvious, Al.
9-8.
Oh, a bit of frustration there from Patterson, by the way.
Yeah. Yeah, didn't like that that miss at all. Just a long serve into the backhand.
Well, I think that's the point I was really trying to make about it's anyone's game. It doesn't feel like that for Patterson. I don't think she feels like it's anyone's game. She's used up her time now.
She wants it.
And she looks a bit more nervous about this fifth set than what...
What a push. She picked the pivot.
Yeah.
Watch this.
Boom. Here. Early pivot from Patterson. She picked it. She went down the line. And you can just see the body language of both players. One's calmer than the other. The team. Team New Zealand nervous about this.
Yeah. Cathy on the bench is just having a drink.
I feel like they didn't mind coming back from 3-2. Where the Kiwis don't want to be 3-2 down.
Good play.
You got that last ball into the middle area and Danger just dragging across.
And she just lifts it up, like you said earlier. She lifts up her body with the stroke. Oh, good serve. Ten. Backspin one.
Oh. Into the middle.
Sucked her into the miss.
Back to 10 all. Crucial points. Players having one serve each here.
Ten.
So that first
11.
Return didn't quite go where Patterson needed it. She got into the back end, needed to just go into the middle a fraction more. Put some pressure on that second push.
The middle, you mean the decision between the backhand and the forehand? Don't make it clear and easy to the backhand.
That's right. It was, that was too easy for yep. Danger to play.
She knew it was a backhand, right?
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Fantastic play. No retreat. No surrender. She kept on it. Good spin. Good counter. Good finish.
And a fist pump.
And a fist pump to follow. 11 all. Juice.
Dang, ooh, just staring
in the eye.
Yeah. And 12, that push down 11, the line again 12. Has been effective.
You said it earlier, Al. I mean, this third place means a lot to these girls. And it's not in the show, but I think the young girl is saying, I'm not fazed by the third position. I just want it. There it is.
13,
the
11,
Kiwis show
game,
their hand
danger,
early. Call the timeout.
Games to two.
That's 7 all in the fifth set.
Game. I think it was 6-5 up.
6-5 up.
Yep.
And game in the balance, still ahead. Calls. If I was a poker player, it's like showing your hand.
Yeah.
And now we see a 13-11 win for Solenn Danger over Natalie Patterson, 3-2.
So now it's going to be a matter of, can Patterson hold it together? She looked a little bit desperate at the end of that. And look at her there. Look at her there.
She's frustration. Patient.
Oh, that's real frustration, you can tell. And just showing it. If Danger, and you know what? Danger just had a little look over at Patterson during that little show of emotion. Danger will be standing there thinking, I think I might be on top. So again, just sneaking a look
the
at
youngster.
What she's doing. Yep. Hopefully listening to Coach Kathy as well.
Coach Kathy knows it's theirs for the taking right now, doesn't she? She's just making sure she gets that message across. Yep. Here's
time.
How you do it. Here's how we finish this girl off.
Yeah, and again, just focusing on that backhand. She wants to punch that backhand through a bit more on the
she
the
wants
block.
A bit more out of it, right?
Yeah, and encouraging Danger to push that ball down the line on from her backhand side to Patterson's forehand. We've seen that work effectively a couple of times.
From a Patterson perspective, the minute was too short, right? No, she needed more time. She just didn't have it there.
There was a little bit of frustration during that
let
minute,
it out
you know,
for the first 30 seconds.
Yeah.
The coach just sat there and took it.
And her face looks a
she's
little
pure.
Bit distressed. Yep.
Six game.
Distressed.
Patterson
so
serving.
Let's see how she copes.
Lovell. Love
and
one.
Unforced error. Looking back at the coach.
It's going to be a lot easier for the youngster to start doing a bit more of what Kathy wants, as long as she stays ahead, right? She'll start pushing that backhand through like she wants. She'll take a little bit of risk now.
Danger needs to put a lot of balls on the table now.
Same, yeah.
Just has to put the ball on the table. Let Patterson make some errors. Get a bit of a lead.
A bit more frustration. Come on, Natalie. How are you going to get out of this one?
She can do it.
She's got to stay calm to start with.
That's not the go. She
love.
Can't be.
Get
can't
back
be
to
made.
Spin, Hal.
Yeah.
Spin, get back to basics.
Push that return. That was too difficult to make a hard,
a hard loop.
Off.
If you are going to loop it, let it drop down. Yeah. Spin that ball up, get some height on it, and challenge the youngster. Make the youngster be junior.
You know, the youngster's going to start to see the finish line shortly.
Yeah. There's that spin. Force it. She's forcing
love
it. The other girl's
more.
Just. Celine's just keeping the ball on the table.
I bet
like
Patterson might would mind
she
her
had
timeout right now. Gone. It's gone. Can we change the rules?
Is she allowed to ask Kathy for the timeout?
Well,
she
can. Can you buy a timeout? I'll give you a point.
If I can have your timeout.
How many points? How many points for a timeout?
Well, she could only afford one at this point.
can't afford too many.
That's right. 1-4. All right, she's on the board again.
We need to take that to the ITTF Rules Committee.
Might as well go and see Michael after this match and see if we can bring it into the game.
Yeah, well, Graham Island's here.
What are you suggesting?
Buy a timeout.
With points. Wow, there's a smack.
5-1.
And which column's that one going, Al?
That's in this column here.
Yeah, she's clawing her way back in that column. Wow. She's got three smacks on, and
well,
she's got
three, five, seven
down. Yeah. She's going to... Oh, we still got time, Al.
Yeah, we do.
If she goes the next six smacks in a row, we get on top. It is a big smack, though, isn't it?
It is.
You can never get enough of seeing that smack. I love it. It is a shot that I don't have in my game, but I wish I did.
Pat hasn't seen enough of it. She's seen three of them.
All three of them.
Yo. Five, so here, danger is only 1 or 2 points away from breaking PATERSON.
Yeah. If you've just joined us, it's the 3-4 playoff, Oceania Cup women's singles, young 17-year-old, Solenn Danger leads 3-2, 5-2, 5-3, until this point it's been in control in the latter part of this game. Alois, what are you seeing now?
I've seen two bad decisions there by Danger. You know, I think
that
she
finish line you mentioned
the
early.
Finish line. She's seen the finish line. Let's see how she holds up.
The game's going at a quicker pace too now, by the way. They're not taking as many bounces in between points. Oh, God. 5-4.
That's a tough point to lose for Danger. She thought she had it.
Just makes a bit
she
more
thought
nerves.
She had it there, and then yeah. And you know when you start to feel things are starting to go against me. I'm almost there.
That's good. She slowed down a little bit there. 4-5. There's that spin I'm talking about. All out wide for the forehand.
Block.
So good expression.
That's the block that Coach Cathy wanted her to make. Let's have a look.
Here it comes.
Pushing through it. Punching through it.
Yeah, nice. Just a small little motion. It's spinny. It's powerful. You don't need to do too much, but it feels like you're doing a lot because of the spin. Good serve.
Wow, that's tough. I like this girl, Danger. Those last 2 points
shows her toughness.
Yeah, she was 5-4. Things were starting to go
put
against
it on
her.
The line.
Yeah, and made a great block, made a great serve.
Let's on the line. I think that's been the difference, Al. The best way to describe is PATERSON wants it. Danger's taking it. PATERSON was protecting it a little bit, you know, that third place.
PATERSON gone to the towel. 4-8 down. She knows she hasn't got too many more opportunities. And there was a bit of a flicker in the light, Simon.
That adds to the...
PATERSON will be hoping that these lights just
go
black
off
out.
Right now. Call it a draw.
She needs
an
hour.
Pack up and go home. There was a draw once.
There was. Australian Junior Boys Final.
Yo! 5.
Stuart Gallagher, Darren Knott, the only players in history to have a draw in table tennis. Anyway, back to the match.
5-8, PATERSON.
We diverse.
Climbing back.
Nine.
Then a fault.
Five.
Oh,
she's pushed it too far. Trying to find that middle. She's gone for the fast serve. It was quick, I must admit. But now she finds herself down 5-9. 2-3.
Still
Coach Cathy exploring the body language of PATERSON.
PATERSON's still looking fairly positive.
Oh. 9-6.
Which column?
That's in that wrong column again.
Yeah,
look at that. The pressure. What a rally, by the way.
Yeah.
Look at this. Good open play.
And PATERSON.
Fast.
Has PATERSON just sort of relaxed a little bit because she can see that, okay, I'm in a tough situation here. And Coach Cathy's arms just went up in the air, and I think I might have seen Simon's arms
move towards the
very
column.
Similarly. I saw a big fist pump by Simon.
No question, that goes in the smack column. What a beautiful shot.
10-6.
Four match balls. for third place.
Bronze medal points.
Seven, ten.
She went where Coach Kathy wanted her to go, pushed the ball down the line, but didn't
focus
execute.
On this young girl's face. 7-10 for the biggest payday in her table tennis career. Biggest moment in her table tennis career. Oh!
11, 7,
she went for it out.
And that ball going off the side, and Solenn Danger takes the bronze medal in the Oceania Cup, and that is a great result for the youngster.
Fantastic. Well, there's the scoreline.
So,
Solenn Danger.
Yep, winning 11-7, 4-11, 6-11, 11-4. That crucial 13-11 in the fifth game,
that
and then
the big one.
Closing it out 11-7 for a 4-2 win. So, exciting times there for New Caledonia, and exciting for this young player to be able to take the bronze medal at such a
huge event.
Have a
look at Coach Kathy, she's wrapped. Well done, guys. What a great effort. Well done, Al. Good job.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Another warm round of applause for that wonderful, wonderful game of table tennis. Congratulations once again to our winner from the